A while back, I melted down several Dollar Tree candles to make a larger candle and held on to the glass jars. I've made one other video using three of the jars, and I'm using the last two for this project. These candle jars have been sitting in my craft room for at least 8 months or so, and there is still some wax residue left inside. So I got my heat gun out to melt the wax again. Then I was able to take a paper towel and clean out the insides. Just be careful if you try something like this because the glass of course gets really hot from the heat gun. This project is super quick and easy. Next, I cut out some Christmas trees on my Cricut, but you can use this sticker to get the same effect. You'll see what I mean here, so don't click off thinking that you need a Cricut to make a similar project. Once I weeded the image out, I'm placing it onto the candle jar, and I put it closer to the bottom rather than in the middle of the jar. Then I lined up the second jar to make sure that they were placed in the same location. Now I'm going to use frosted glass spray paint and cover the glass jars. I gave it two coats of the spray paint, and the last time that I tried to use this stuff, I didn't think it was working, but I realized it goes on clear, and as it dries, it turns frosted. So when I added the second coat, the whole thing got clear again and then dried frosty. I was so confused and thought I had ruined it. When the spray paint was dry, I'm removing the tree decal to reveal that clear glass behind it. This is why I said you can easily use a sticker to do this project and get the same exact look. The one thing you want to be careful of here is not to scratch the frosted glass. I was using my weeding tool to remove the trees, and my hand slipped at one point. There is a tiny little scratch in the frosted part, but you really can't tell. And that's it for this one, super quick and easy. I'm just adding some battery tea lights inside for that warm glow. For this project, I'm using paper towel rolls to make some Christmas candles. At first, I was only gonna have a set of three candles, but then decided to add four more. So you're only gonna see three here at first. But I'm cutting them down to be varying heights, and no two candles are gonna be the same height. Now you could leave the rolls just like this and paint them, but I of course wanted to take it a step further and give them some texture while disguising the fact that they're paper towel rolls a little bit better. So I'm taking some joint compound and covering the entire surface of the rolls. Once they were dry, I'm using a 220 grit sandpaper to smooth them out. There is still gonna be some divots left in the joint compound, and that's okay. I didn't want them to be completely smooth. I love the way these are starting to turn out with that texture. Next, I need to add in the tea lights. I have these ones from when I made a similar project using pool noodles last Halloween, but I had painted them black. So I now need to make them white again, and I taped off the candle flame so I don't get paint on that part, and then painted all the tea lights. The tea lights are just a little bit smaller than the opening of the paper towel rolls, so I stuffed some paper down inside of the tubes so that the light can rest on it, and then I was able to glue them in. Now, to make them look even more like melting candles, we of course need to add in the dripping wax. I'm using hot glue and just adding globs of it so that it starts to drip down the sides. This does use a lot of hot glue sticks. I think I used four or five of the longer ones. On the smaller candles, I added a few layers of the hot glue since they would have melted a lot more than the candles that are still tall. This footage is so satisfying to watch sped up. For the rest of the display, you could use either a rectangular tray, which I'm showing here. I thought I was gonna go this route, but Once I saw the candles on the circular tray, I decided I liked this one better. But before I decorate the tray, I still need to paint the candles. I'm using that same off-white paint that I used for the tea lights and gave all the candles 2 coats. I had painted the tray black once before, but I wanted a more metallic look for this project. You really don't see the tray in the end, so this isn't necessary, but I spray painted it burnished amber. Now I can remove the tape from the flames, and at this point I had a moment of panic. I was gonna hot glue them down onto the tray, but then I had realized I would not be able to turn them on and off. I also have that paper inside of them, which makes it a little bit more annoying. But I'm glad I had thought not to glue them down in place before it was too late. It's still gonna be a little bit annoying to pull them out of the display every time I wanna turn the lights on though. It's time to decorate and make this arrangement look pretty. I picked up some floral picks from Michael's and I laid them out around the base of the candles. I love to have a variety of picks in my displays using different colors. I used a few different styles of pine with different tones of green, but they are all flocked to tie everything together and make it look cohesive. I also added in some little lamb's ear berry picks and non-flocked pine, and I think this turned out so beautiful. This is another super quick and easy project. It's not exactly trash, but I'm recycling all of the materials from past Christmas seasons to give them a new life. I'm starting with this glass vase and going to tape off an oval shape with washi tape. You want to either use a thin tape or make a smaller looking oval if you use something thicker like masking tape. I found the washi tape to be super easy to mold to the shape since it's so thin. Next, I'm taking some Mod Podge. This one is actually decoupage glue, but same thing, and spreading it onto the vase. You want to work in small sections here. This first section was way too much, so for the rest of the vase, I only went halfway up with my Mod Podge. Then I'm taking this faux snow and pressing it into the Mod Podge. On this first section, my Mod Podge was already starting to dry, so the faux snow didn't stick as well. So that's why I said to work in even smaller sections. Also have a plate or something to catch that snow underneath of the vase for easy cleanup. I did try to go back over that first section and add more glue. That didn't work out so well. The snow was just sticking to my sponge and lifting it up. I was able to get it to look a little bit fuller though. I set the vase aside for a few minutes just to make sure it was all dry before removing the washi tape. This thing is going to shed a little bit and that's just the nature of it. Next, I'm adding some of the snow into the bottom of the vase, just a little bit, not too much, and then placing a bottle brush tree inside. This is almost looking like a little snow globe. You could stop here and it would be a super cute little shelf sitter for the holidays, but I had these LED puck lights that I bought for another project and never ended up using. It was the perfect size to sit on top of the vase and then I can light up the jar. This adds such a high-end look and I love it and is so excited that the batteries were already included. But of course, I don't just want to set the light on top of the vase. So first I got out some velvet ribbon to cover up the edges of the puck light. I just hot glued this on and if I ever want to remove it, I easily can. Then I got out these vintage picks that my mom gave me years ago. I've never had an idea of what to do with them until now. I had almost donated them at one point, but I'm so glad that I didn't. Then I just added in a few little pit berries here and there for one more element, and that's it for this one. I love it and it was so easy to do. For this project, I'm using an empty wine bottle. I love how you can see the layers of stained glass from how long it took us to drink this, but I'm painting the whole bottle white and it's going to get covered up. I gave the bottle two coats and painted in a crosshatch motion. So the first coat of paint, I used horizontal brushstrokes, and the second coat, I did vertical. This just helps provide more coverage. Typically with white, I end up needing three coats, so this helped. I'm turning this into a little snowman, so once the paint was dry, I just grabbed a little piece of fabric to see where the hat's gonna sit. I made a mark there so I know where to start the face on him. Next, I drew on his face with pencil, and then I outlined it with a Micron pen before going in with my paints. I'm gonna let the painting part play so you can see how I did everything, but feel free to skip forward if you aren't interested in seeing this part. On the nose, I blended a few colors of paint to try and get a more realistic but still painterly look. I used orange, brown, and white for this. After I painted his face on, I'm gonna add a hat. I had this vintage looking striped fabric in my stash and I cut a piece down to wrap around the bottle. At the top of the hat, I bunched the fabric together and then I used a strip of the fabric to tie around it. Then I tucked the excess fabric inside the bottle opening. I wanted the top to look like a palm, so I glued some of these large pom-poms that I have around the top of the bottle. And that's it for this guy. He is so adorable. For this project, I'm using some cardboard from a box, and yes, I have a spot of white paint right on the butt of my black pants, but I'm using this to create a window scene in my front window for the holidays. I'm measuring the width of my window so I know how long this cardboard section needs to be. I'm using the cardboard to make a row of houses, and that's gonna sit right along the bottom section of my window. So next, I need to outline the shape of each house. I wanted them all to look a little bit different, some short, some tall, some narrow, some wide, and all with different roof lines. Then once I had the houses outlined, I cut the whole thing out in one piece with my X-Acto knife. I realized later I forgot to add chimneys to the houses in my middle window section, but I did add them onto the two smaller side windows. I could have added some in with toothpicks, but I just left them how they were. After the house row was cut out, I added windows, and again, I wanted them all to look a little bit different. This time, when I cut the windows out, I used my utility knife. My X-Acto knife blade was pretty dull here, and I didn't have any replacement blades. I wanted to make sure that the cuts were clean and not jagged looking, so make sure you use a sharp knife for this. Now comes the fun part of decorating the houses. I bought a variety pack of white chalk markers from Amazon, and I'll link them in my description box, but it came with 5 different size markers. I used those to add little details into each house, outlining the windows, adding snow to the roofs, making it look like there were lights around some of the windows. Again, they are all different. Once all my houses were decorated, I'm gonna add them to the bottom of my windows, and I used double-sided tape so they would stay in place. Then I had to wait for it to get dark outside. That way you guys can actually see what I'm doing here, but there is still going to be a reflection from my room. Anyways, for the rest of the window, I wanted to draw a little scene with the chalk markers. Here you can see better what they look like in the different sizes. I found the center of my big window first so I can draw a swag. This took me a few attempts to get it to look good, but it's super easy to wipe off the mistakes you make with a paper towel or a Q-tip. Then I added some lines straight down from the swag. I'm gonna add some hanging ornaments here, again, making them all look a little bit different. I did repeat a couple of the ornaments, but for the most part, they're different. I wanted the swags to look more like pine greenery, so I just drew diagonal lines over and over, almost looking like little arrows on either side of the initial line that I drew. I knew I was gonna do this, but I waited until after the ornaments were on, so that way it would look like the ornaments were coming from inside of the garland, rather than trying to draw the lines to look like they were behind it. This just makes it look a little bit better. And the last little touch for my winter scene, of course, we need to add some snow. I wanted the snow to look heavy at the top of the window, like it was just starting to snow, and the size and the spacing of the snowflakes would spread out as it started to fall down the window and onto the houses. I didn't show it, but along the bottom in front of the houses, I did add on some pillow stuffing as snow and fairy lights. And that's it for my little scene. I love how this turned out.